हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर हियर टू लर्न व्हाट इज़ मेमोरी मैप्ड आईओ एंड आईओ मैप्ड आईओ। स्टूडेंट्स, इनपुट आउटपुट डिवाइसेस दैट इज आल्सो कॉल्ड पेरिफेरल्स कैन बी कनेक्टेड विद माइक्रोप्रोसेसर इन टू मोड्स, दैट इज मेमोरी मैप्ड आईओ एंड आईओ मैप्ड आईओ। In IO mapped IO, the memory and IO devices are treated separately. It means the memory addresses are not similar for both IO and memory. As an example, consider the instruction out 02. Here the 02H is the address of a output port and which is of 1 byte only. Whereas we know that the addresses for memory in 8085 should be of 2 bytes. Then why the address provided in out 02 is of 1 byte? This is because the IO devices are not treated as memory and addresses are also designed separately for IO and memory. On the other hand, in memory mapped IO, the addresses are similar for both IO and memory. There are no instructions like in 01 or out 02. Both IO devices and memory are treated as same. We can differentiate both IO mapped IO and memory mapped IO using following table. As we can see in the table, number of address lines required in memory mapped IO for memory is 16 and for IO is also 16. Control signals are MEMR bar and MEMW bar, and for IO these are also same. But in IO mapped IO, the address lines required for memory are 16, whereas the address lines required in for IO are 8, and the control signals which are required for memory are MEMR bar and MEMW bar, but for IO devices the control signals are not same as memory. These will be IOR bar and IOW bar. Number of peripherals or memory which can be connected in memory mapped IO considering 8085 are 64 kilobyte memory plus IO both. It means we can address only 64 kilobyte memory, including IO devices and memory. Whereas in IO mapped IO, we can address 64 kilobyte memory separately and 256 byte memory for IO. Advantages of memory mapped IO and IO mapped IO are as IO MBAR not required in memory mapped IO because the IO MBAR signal differentiate between IO and memory, but here the IO and memory is treated as same, so IO MBAR signal is not required. Separate instructions are not required as in 01 out 02 because there is no difference in memory and IO. We can perform operations directly with IO data like memory. As we are treating the IO devices same as memory, so we can apply our operations like addition, subtraction and other instructions similarly as like instructions on the registers. Whereas the advantage of IO mapped IO is interfacing is less complex because only 8 address lines are required. Max capacity of microprocessor is used. Maximum capacity is used because the 8085 can only address 64 kilobyte of memory. But in this mode, we can additionally use 256 locations for input output devices. Disadvantage of memory mapped IO. Interfacing is complex because there are 16 address lines, and we have to derive the interfacing logic for memory and IO devices to connect in our system. Less memory addresses due to sharing by memory and as well as IO. The disadvantage of IO mapped IO is IO devices require separate instructions, so we have to learn more instructions for using the IO devices, like in out. Operations cannot be performed directly on IO data because the IO devices are treated separately, so we cannot consider to use our instructions like addition, subtraction on IO data directly. We have to first input data and output data using our input output instructions. Extra control signals IOR and IOW are required. So this is the difference between memory mapped IO and IO mapped IO. Thank you.